Shut up and sit down.
The Dragon Flag. Arguably the coolest core movement and definitely one of the coolest exercises out there. Created by Bruce Lee and popularized by Rocky IV. Today I wanted to show you some of my best tips for a progression towards conquering this movement. If you stay consistent with my advice, as well as make sure that you're eating well, you're sleeping well, you're warming up before your workouts and cooling down after, you should be able to achieve success with this movement in about 2 months or 8 weeks of training. But if you're more of an intermediate to advanced exerciser, you may be dragon flagging even sooner. So the plan is basically divided into two different months. The first month is going to be more for your beginners or those who are a bit more new to fitness overall. Whereas the second month, that's going to be where you're likely going to want to start if you're more of an intermediate to advanced exerciser. But of course, regardless of your fitness level, you're more than welcome to start at the beginning of the plan. Now again, this is an 8 week long program that is going to be split into 4 2-week long workouts. Each workout should be done 3 times per week, ideally with at least 1 day of rest between each workout, so like a Monday, Wednesday, Friday kind of thing. Lastly, I'm gonna want you to complete 2 sets of each exercise within the workout and make sure that you're going to failure for each exercise, unless you are a true beginner. Then for your first couple of weeks, I want you to challenge yourself, but don't push it to failure. Obviously, dragon flags are going to be a fantastic way to build up that six pack. But if you want to reveal the six pack, you got to make sure your calories are under control or you're doing enough cardio or both. Let's go. For the first 2 weeks of the beginner plan, we're starting off with a couple of standard plank variations. First on our forearms and then on our hands. We do this to activate and establish a strong core, but planking essentially challenges your entire body in a safe way, so it's a fantastic preliminary exercise in general. To specifically target your back and glutes, we're doing Superman pulses next. The final exercise is going to be a leg raise with both knees tucked. This is basically a modified leg raise that will help prepare your body for similar, more challenging movements down the line. Keep in mind that most of the laying exercises can also be done with a bench or on the floor. For the next 2 weeks, we're starting again with a plank, but we're going to make it a bit more dynamic by alternating between a plank on the hands and a downward facing dog. After that, you'll be doing another leg raise, but this time, challenge the movement by extending one leg out. Be sure to do the opposite leg as well. Next, we'll be holding the Superman pose instead of pulsing. Follow that with a flutter kick and finish with a V-up. Assuming you've completed the first 4 weeks, it's time to move on to the intermediate to advanced workouts. Start with a single leg raise, and then for the next exercise, extend both legs. By this point, you should be able to add a little hip hop to the leg raise. But if you're not quite there yet, do another set of standard leg raises. And then finish the circuit with a set of V-ups. Moving on to the final, most challenging 2 weeks, here we're starting with the leg raise with the hip hop, activating the lower back again with the Superman hold, and then a set of standard leg raises. At this point, your core should be nice and warm. The final movement of the circuit is a dragon flag that focuses on the eccentric portion of the movement. Do a leg raise with a hip hop, but keep your body straight and fight gravity as you lower. And there you have it. After these final 2 weeks, give the complete dragon flag a try. A powerful, impressive movement. And if nothing else, a cool party trick. If you enjoyed the workout, please consider liking and subscribing. Hopefully, we'll be training together again soon.